Hey guys, how's it going? My name's Dolly's and welcome back to Infinity Skyblock, the expert mode mod pack where everything is so difficult to craft. Last time, I believe we made this. I do believe that is the last episode. We made the mob farm, and that gave us the gunpowder to make the blast furnace. And we are kind of on our way to make some more stuff. I have a ton, and I mean a ton of ore right here. And I need to make some stuff. So let's put that in there for right now. I want to make some stuff and kind of go over what I've been doing off camera. So I want this pattern chest. I would love to have another pattern chest, but one is fine for now. We're going to put this in here. Last time, did we end up making... I don't see it. I need a gear. We could make it out of wood. By the way, I have a chest over here. Just got a bunch of stuff. And we'll get to all that in a little bit. I haven't really done anything over here. With all of this stuff. But I mean... ton of stuff. I just grabbed just, oh wow, a sickening amount of stuff, and I have dirt, so much dirt. But basically, let's see what's in the common treasure. Let's might be lucky. Gold. That's okay. So the big thing that I want to do today, and let's put gold there. So this is going to be my metals chest. Basically, I'm going to bring anything from sifting over here and put it in here. But today, the big goals that I want to do, first of all, I want to get crops going. We need a lot of specific seeds. Actually, I can turn all of these into sticks. Let's make a gear, and then the rest are going to be crops. I need the gear because we're going to be making a cast for it. This is incredibly important, and we have gold in there. Alright, so for example, I know that the carpenter requires gears. I need a gear cast. Metal. Do I have to have a stone gear? Because I know gold will work, but... I think it might have to be stone. Yep. Alright. Wooden gears won't work. Let's get some stone. Do I have any? Yeah, I have stone on me. Stone's not that difficult to make. Just upgrade it. And there we go. Awesome. So wooden gear wouldn't work. It would just... that makes sense. It would just melt immediately. But we'll need that for later. For now, we are going to... I'm going to continue making... metal in there, and let's go talk about this. So this is all of the seeds that I need. By the way, it took forever to get all of the signs. And what do we have here? This is, hey, that's something I need. So I will get into what I'm going to do with this guy, but let's break him for right now. I need to put some sort of check mark on these, so let's put a piece of cobblestone next to them if I have them done. So as you can see, I've been doing a little bit of work off camera, trying to get things settled. And let's see, this one is done, this one is done because that's pumpkin. Did we get melon? We have melons, so I need that though, because I'm gonna need to spread that, and I'll get into what that means in just a minute. So we have the poppy, I know that. But yeah, so this is all the seeds that I'm gonna need in order to make the watering can and the presser so that we can make the culinary generator. Now there is, actually no, not the watering can. Why? I keep thinking it's the watering can. Why is it that I wanted the bean seeds? What is this used for? This is so that I can make the. Where is it? I thought bean was important for something. So, soybeans. That's why. Derp. So I need soybeans. But yeah, so as you can see, it's a lot of stuff. And then what I've been doing, so I don't think I need scallions anymore. I'm gonna break these, both of them, and let's get beans and melons. So melons, I could honestly do something like this. Get melon seeds this way. Actually, that might be easier. So let's do that a couple times. But I don't believe I can. Oh, I can. Awesome. So I can make more seeds. So my big concern was I don't want to lose all of my seeds. Because seeds are kind of precious. And what I've been doing is basically going around. So I know that melons and dandelions. That's how we get dandelions. So we do that. We bone meal them. And we do that, and then double crop sticks will allow for mutations. So what is this guy? That's the melon. Let's put him here. And if we need another melon, we'll get one. So poppy and dandelion. But yeah, as you can see, it's going to take me some time. I'm going to get a lot of things that aren't right. Let's go bone meal the bean. I don't actually need this spreading thing anymore. I think the only thing I'll need it for is I'm gonna need two beans. The only thing I'm gonna need it for is the flowers. So I'll just keep that in mind. Let's go ahead and break these. And sugarcane, obviously. But I don't want to lose any seeds. That's why I'm doing all of this. So beans, and let's do crop sticks. So we need beans here. I'm actually making a lot more progress than I originally thought. So we need rye. That's barley. Nope. And yeah, so eventually I will have all of the stuff that I need. Is this dandelions? Alright, so this is one that is done. So I'll put the block there, and I just need to go plant them, bone meal them, and let them spread. So the way this works is when a crop is fully grown in the crop sticks, it has a chance to spread. If there is something else here, it will mutate. And the mutations, I've went over this briefly before, it's how I got the sugarcane. The mutations will let you get other things. So that is what I'm having to do with all of this stuff. And honestly, so I'm gonna need like a handful of dandelions. But once I can get all of this stuff, then it'll be a lot of trying to get all the seeds that I need and whatnot. I'm also running low on food, because I will show you that in a second. Food's not easy to get in this map. Seeds. I kind of have to babysit some of these, but you get the general idea. I'm going to do a lot of this off camera. I'm hoping to have all of this done before the next episode. I will still need to make the watering can, which is going to take beets, corn, which I'll get from this, and kiwi, which... strawberry, radish. So it looks like it comes off of tomatoes, which isn't too bad. There's a couple there. Peas. I will get cabbage, okra, leek, celery. Okay, so some of those I'm gonna have. Eventually I need to have a nice organized system of like all the seeds that I have, and some of them I will be doing 10-10-10s. So let's throw what we can in there. Let's take this stuff out. I'll probably crossbreed some cactus for the normal cactus stuff. but for now, it's kind of whatever. I'm going to take all the carrots, because I don't need... I have carrot seeds. I don't need the carrots in there. I don't need the signs in there. Alright, so that's kind of the crash course on what I'm doing over there, which is to get all the stuff so that we can get culinary generators, and that is going to be big. Once we can get culinary generators, power will be kind of solved. But the interesting thing that I wanted to bring up is I have all this raw chicken. I can't cook it right now. You need to have a redstone furnace. You cannot use or an oven, which an oven I don't believe is that easy to make. Let's see. Where is oven? Actually, that's not too bad. That's just a lot of iron. You know what? Let's make that, because food is an issue. I've been eating carrots more than anything else. Let's get iron going. But let's see. Nickel. Sorry, ferrous. Becomes ferrous. It's both nickel and ferrous. It does count as both, but so let's get iron ingot there, aluminum, ferrous. Alright, so hey, we already have a block of steel. That's gonna be good, because we're gonna need a lot of steel relatively soon. We need to put some more coal in there. Does this work? If I put this in a coke oven, it does. Alright, awesome. Actually, I want to double check that it will convert back, because sometimes in this mod pack things don't convert back. Okay, it does. So let's throw that in there. It will burn up into I don't know where I'm putting that. I have, are they in here? They are. But there's a stack in the mod already. You know what? Let's grab these. And there we go. So lava is something I could use more of. And yeah, I just need to get a lot of automation going. But one of the things that I want to make relatively soon is this rock crusher. It's going to take 4 diamonds, 4 pistons, and a block of steel. That's pretty expensive, and I need it's a 3x2x2, so it's 6, let's see, it's 12 blocks, so I need 3 recipes of that. So I need 3 blocks of steel. Let's go ahead and add another iron block in there and see if it won't finish cooking. That's going to take forever to cook. I probably should have done some of this off camera. I forgot about that. But I didn't look at the recipe for the rock crusher. So yeah, these are burn times 3200 ticks. So I have like 64. Yeah, it's not gonna make it. But oh well. You know what, let's not waste stuff. Let's take this out. Can I make, okay, I can. So let's just put iron in there. What converts, converts, what doesn't, doesn't. Alright, I don't want to cook all of this on camera, but I want to make this oven, which, let's see how bad it, what was it? So, furnace, that's not too bad. Let's get a stack of cobblestone, and make a furnace, because it takes 81 cobblestone to make a furnace. That's fun. Then we're going to need some iron. I need to eat. This is why I'm making this oven. Now I do believe this oven, if we want to look at the uses of this, The oven requires cooking oil, which is... Yeah, that's not going to be fun. Sesame seeds, grape seeds, cotton seeds, olives, avocado, pumpkin seeds. All right, so we're going to need a presser, which is actually what we're trying to get anyway, so that'll be okay. We can press pumpkin seeds and get oil. All right, so while that is going, let's get some copper. We're going to need a lot of copper and tin for the other thing that I want to try to make today. So let's get some iron bars. We are going to need more iron. And there's the oven. So put the oven down. Put the chicken in there, because I will show off that I can't even put it in here. Won't do anything. Just sits there. You can't cook food in the furnace. And I don't believe... Oh, hey, I can't... Oh, cool. I can use coal. Does it... And it gives me cooked chicken. Awesome. So this block will solve our food problems. Awesome. Let's get more blocks out. Let's put all this stuff in here. And I can get rid of the oven for right now. Alright, so next thing I want to work towards, because let's take a look at the in-game guide. So the tech tree, so power options, that's what we're working on. I'm trying to skip ahead to the culinary generator because that seems to be the easiest. But then the next thing that we're going to want to do is we need to make some machines so that we can make better machines. Because I've shown this off, but let's say the redstone furnace. Basic machine from thermal expansion. It takes bricks, that's easy. Copper gears, that's easy. Redstone reception coil, simple. Redstone. But then it takes machine frames. So... Basic machine frame requires a basic circuit board from forestry, an iron chipset, crushed obsidian, dense refined iron plates, and a tin gear. The iron chipset is made in an assembly table, as is the machine frame, so we'll need an assemblies table, which means we're going to need power as well, which is why I'm making culinary generators. I'm skipping right to culinary generators because they're going to be better for power in the long run. We're going to need a basic circuit board, which is not too complicated, but it does require a carpenter. The tin gear isn't anything. Crushed obsidian is obsidian in a rock crusher, which I believe, I think this takes power. I don't remember. But that's gonna take the 3 steel blocks and 12 diamonds, 12 pistons. So yeah, nasty, but not the end of the world. Can I use that obsidian powder? I can, I think. Cool. And anyway, so the last thing is the dense refined iron plates, which requires 9 iron or steel plates. So the refined iron plates will need a metal former to make, which will probably be the best way. And it's any kind of steel. Be metal formed into refined iron plates, and then we can press it into dense iron plates. So we'll need IC2 machines. Now to get, like, let's just look at the compressor. I don't think this is gonna be easy. So the compressor is some stone, basic machine casing, and an electronic circuit. Basic machine casing, iron plates, iron chipset. Not actually as bad as I kind of thought. Iron chipset, again, we'll need an assembly table. That's not too bad. Electronic circuit is iron plates, insulated rubber, insulated copper cable, just rubber and cable. That's not too bad, actually. But that is copper plates, either with a metal former or with cutters, which iron and iron plates, not too bad. Annoying, but not too bad. So the compressor is not too bad, but we are going to need the metal former, So this guy is a pain. So electronic circuit basing machine casing, we've seen those. Coils are copper cables with iron in the middle. That's easy. Then these toolboxes, which are bronze item casings, which are bronze plates. That's not too bad, actually. That's actually not too bad. So we could do that pretty easily. But we are going to need IC2 power. That's going to be probably the hardest part about that. But, not too bad. But to get started with all that, we need to make forestry machine. So we're going to need 2 glass, 6, 10, and we're going to need a lot of bronze. Okay, so let's get some bronze started. Bronze, I believe, is a 3 copper one. Let's put that there. Let's get some more copper out. I'm trying to think. So let's look at Tinker's. No, it's an alloy. If I just type alloy. Okay, so how about bronze? Let's just look bronze up. Bronze gear. Bronze. Alright, so why am I struggling to find? Alright, let's just look at copper loads. So uses of this, molten copper, smelter, there we go. So molten bronze is, it's a 3-to-1 ratio and it gives you 4. Alright, so at least that's good to know. Let's get that in there. Actually, let's make some ingots and do that. So, 1, 2, 3. So, if we do something like this, we can do 3 sets. 1, 2, 3. And let's go grab the bucket. Get some lava out. Eventually we will automate the lava production. We'll make a bunch of these. I don't know why I can't take it, but whatever. There we go. Let's get plenty of lava in here. So we're gonna make some bronze. And first thing we need is to get 4, we need 4 gears and then a whole bunch of actual bronze. So let's see, didn't all melt down, that's odd, my counting off, it's 3-to-1, so, oh, my counting's off, so it's like that, so 6 and 2, so there's an extra, we'll do like that, and I think that will even it out. Hopefully it will. If there's any excess, we'll deal. But let's get first block of bronze out. Let's grab some chicken. We should have plenty of coal. Throw a bunch in there. I haven't been using all the slab furnaces. Honestly, I should probably... Let's condense it, actually. Let's just get one. If I need others, I can deal with them later. But let's get, we're gonna need some glass, so we need more sand. Let's just get a handful of glass. And then, by then, let's get this. This needs more. Hopefully that's enough. Alright, so let's get the gravel. And we're at least going to make the carpenter today. Then I will try to get some of the stuff together for the other things as we go along. So we need a whole bunch of bronze. We have 6 diamonds right now, so we don't have enough diamonds for the whatchamacallit, the rock crusher yet. And that's something I need to look into. I don't remember if that takes power or not. Like at all. But let's see, we have plenty of bronze. So we have 6 nuggets of tin. Let's put one more copper in there. Hopefully that's enough. And then let's get some gears. The nice thing is, if we ever need more copper gears, or if we ever need any more gears or anything like that, we have, as long as we have the metals, we can just easily melt things down and get stuff that we need. So that's 3, 4. Alright, so this should be enough materials. Hopefully, let's watch. Awesome. We'll get the rest of it out. So we need, I think it's like this. Is that the casing? No. Other way around. Alright, I can handle that. So there's the sturdy casing. That is expensive. Put that there. And there we go. So there's the carpenter. We have a machine we really can't do anything with yet. Because, well, we don't have any power generation yet. But we'll get there. Let's get some chests. And put that away. Alright, so I'm gonna make a chest of things. So this will be kind of, let's put it here. And it's going to have steel, bronze, and then any machines or anything that we can't really use yet. So there is the carpenter. Now the other thing that we're going to need, relatively soon actually, other than the rock crusher, is we're going to need a thermionic, I thought I could spell that, thermionic. How do you spell it? Thermionic fabricator. There we go. So that's very similar. It's another sturdy casing. And some gold. And a gold chest. Oh, that's going to be a little bit of a pain. But let's get another 4 gears if we can. I'm assuming these take 4 ingots worth. Let's see, we have 5. I'm gonna assume that they do, so let's get 1, 2, 3. Yep. Alright, so once that melts, we'll have everything we need. Let's see if we can't make this as well. So we're gonna need iron chests, so we need some we just need some wood. And I've been keeping some wood on me, and then I've been putting everything in there as we go, just because it's easier. So let's make a chest, and then we're going to need this guy and a bunch of iron. They melt. Yay. Cool. I can't remember if it's... Yeah, so it's 2 iron, so we need 16 iron. Wow. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. That will give us the iron chest. Let's see, we need 4 of these. We're gonna need a lot of gold. I think more than we have. But let's get some gold smelted up. Actually, we should have just enough gold to do this. So if we can get this machine, it'd be very nice. The thermionic fabricator, by the way, what are we going to need it for? Let's see, because this makes the electron tubes. So the basic, like the copper electron tubes, pretty easy to make. There's a bunch of them. They go all the way up to like, what are some of the ender electron tubes? And this stuff we're gonna need for high level. I don't even know. Okay, we'll probably never need the copper. Tin looks like it makes farms. And, ooh, there's what we're gonna need it for. Let's do an energy cell. So we're gonna need electronic circuits, which those are not too bad to make, but we're gonna need the tin electron tubes to store energy. That's something I like to do pretty quickly. So yeah, having the thermionic fabricator pretty early is gonna be good. Don't really need the trade station, so iron's not gonna be super useful. But gold is going to get us alveolaries, looks like, and some farm control stuff, which I don't plan on using farms. Gold are gonna get us, or not gold, but diamond is gonna give us the lasers. That's what's important. So if we take a look at what's it called, the assembly table. This takes a diamond gear, which is a gold gear with some diamonds, just a standard diamond and obsidian and redstone. Nothing, honestly, that difficult. But it's the rest of the stuff that's the pain. So, let's take this out. I don't think we have enough gold. Do I have any more gold in here? No. So I'm gonna have to sift some stuff later. By the way, I discovered that appetite it crafts into blocks, as well as I don't know if I said this on camera or not, but flint and coal, obviously. We do have a block of coal coke. That is good. This does keep. I forgot about that. All right, so we need 8 of these. So let's get 8 gold plates, and we need just one more iron, one more gold, so we should barely have enough. Wow. All right, let's pick up that forge hammer. It's pretty expensive. So let's go ahead and make the thermionic fabricator. And honestly, I think after that, I'm going to go ahead and call this episode because I have some crops to deal with. So gold chest. 2, 3 gold ingots. Wait, no. How? What? How does it look? I already forgot. We're 1 gold short. Oh, that is frustrating. Well, technically we're not. So let's get gold. Let's pull that out, and we'll put the ingot cast here. All right, so. That in there. I need to expand. Storage is a pain in this. I need to make barrels for all of the gunpowder and rotten flesh and all that stuff. Eventually, I will kind of automate the collection of all the goodies. But for now, I don't need to. Let's see. That's barley. Anything else? So that did its thing. We have some dandelions. Alright, so we have dandelion seeds. Let's switch these. So dandelions go here. I'm not gonna worry about growing those yet. But blue orchids are dandelions and poppies. So let's do this. And hopefully we can get what we need. Honestly, we're not doing too bad. Poppy and blue orchid. And yeah, so some of these once they're done, I probably should just clear them out. But I wanted to show off on camera. All of this stuff. So I think what I'm gonna do is actually just clear these out. Once they are done. And then I can use this stuff later. I might set up another set of stuff. Ooh, what's that? Seeds. Dang it. I have seen it do the other one, so I know that it will, it's not like broken or anything. So if there's nothing there, take it up. This one can be broken. Awesome. So yeah, my inventory is full. Let's eat some carrots. And those are poppies. Alright, I need to get rid of some of this stuff. Alright, let's run back real quick and drop off like all this stuff and get the gold out of the system. Alright, I'm good enough. Let's hit that. We just need one right now. Like I said, I will spend some time between episodes kind of getting things all taken care of. Alright, so making progress. Pick this one up because I don't need it. And yeah, so once we get most of stuff taken care of, get all the stuff that we need, things should be a lot easier. And then I will start laying out things for a proper farm. Please be, nope. Alright, so I'm just kind of waiting on two. Let's get rid of a whole bunch of stuff and pick up all that other stuff. And I think before next episode, I will also get the stuff prepared to make the analyzer, the seed analyzer, so we can see what we're getting. But there's the thermionic fabricator. That is important. We'll get to making other stuff with it later, but for now it's important that we just have it. But I think, wow, that did not last as long as I wished it would. I'm gonna let this run for a while. I'm gonna take care of crops. I'm gonna chop down a bunch of trees, get a whole bunch of chests because I need more chests, and wait on the poppies and dandelions to give me blue orchids. Dang. And wait on the wheat and the barley to give me rye. Once I get those, I'll be able to spread all that stuff out pretty quickly and kind of go from there. So I need blue orchids pretty badly. I need blue orchids there. I don't know if I need them anywhere else. Honestly, I might just put them there and kind of move them as needed. But I will clean this area up a little bit and, like I said, work on getting more metals, try to get some more diamonds. Something I might do, depends on how much string do I have. Let's actually, might do that on camera right now. Does this mod pack have it? Let's get rid of all that. So there is a, yes, so heavy oak sieve requires heavy silk mesh, which is kind of cool. Logs and sticks. I might actually do that instead of what I have been. So let's get this. So we need 2, 3, 4. So I'm gonna need more string, which I should be able to handle. If I go over to my mob farm, should have more string. Let's kill the witch. Maybe not. I don't seem to be getting all that many spiders. Getting a few, but I need more string. So I might try to get more string. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to make the heavy oak sieve. The reason being, It does some really nice things. Namely, it allows you to... Oh my god, I have so much stuff. I'm going to try to sort this inventory problems out. Probably chop down a whole bunch of trees and make some barrels. I don't believe I made that barrel. So I've made barrels before on camera, so I'm going to do that off camera. Just kind of simple crafting. But yeah, so I'm going to chop down a bunch of trees. I'm going to try to get some more string, get some heavy sieves. And what they do is if you... I could get a compressed hammer, which is 9 stone hammers. It's actually not all that good to do it that way, I don't think. It might be, actually. But then I can compress cobblestone, hammer it into compressed gravel, or actually hammer it into gravel, and then sift the gravel compressed. So what I can do is, you know, get like a bunch of stacks of this, compress it all, and then I would be able to, rather than sifting, essentially it's the same odds as, rather than sifting one gravel at a time, it's like sifting 9. So it's definitely useful. So I can get like one more. There we go. So like I have 45 compressed cobble. Yeah, I don't think I'm gonna do it that way. I think I'm gonna actually hammer them out with the normal hammers. It'd be 45 versus like, actually no, that, you know, that is actually cheaper. Never mind. So I'm gonna get the like stupid strong hammer. So let's get a bunch of sticks. I need 9, 18. So let's just keep chopping down trees. And I'm gonna do this as a demonstration. I'm gonna do it more off camera, but let's get a bunch of wood. So 18. And then what we can do is come over here and do 1, 2, 1, like that. Drop them on the floor. There we go. Wait, what was those? Huh, stone shears. I wish I would have known about those. I feel silly for making wood shears. Stone shears are the way to go. I will keep that in mind. But we can make this compressed stone hammer, and then what we can do is if we put compressed stone down, we can hammer it. It takes a little bit, but it will give us a lot of gravel. And then once I get the heavy oak sieve, what I can do is compress the gravel and then sift that. So that should give us what? I don't even know how many I did. 8. So now I have 8 compressed gravel, and that's going to let me do a lot more sifting quicker. It's just an efficiency type thing, but it is useful. So I am going to work on that. I'm going to get more stuff, and get more stuff. So that sums up everything. I'll also get more stuff. So I'm gonna cycle through all this stuff and get all the ores out. Other than what I can't, obviously, but I have a lot of work to do, and yeah. So I'm going to do that. Hopefully. Yes, we got rye. Awesome. I will deal with that off camera. And oh, poppies. Dang it. So hopefully I can get all the seeds that I need. So we have rye. That is wonderful. Where does it go? Don't need these anymore. Can I turn? I can't turn. Yes, I can turn wheat into seeds, but it's not going to be useful. But I can turn barley into seeds, which I thought was going to be useful, but it's not. Well. I don't know what to throw out. There we go. Alright, so we have rye. Let's get this. That is rice, I know that much. Corn, barley. There we go. Barley and rye. Need to plant it before I can bone meal. And then... awesome. So I am going to work on trying to get everything I can. And yeah, like I said, I will go from there. Hopefully I will have this done and get most, if not all, the diamonds that I need for the rock crusher so that we can start next episode getting into power. So that's going to be huge. So anyways, I hope you guys enjoyed this episode, and I will see you guys in the next one. Bye!